Hey guys, hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So today in this particular video we are going to take 10 questions from pericyclic reactions. So basically this particular topic, which is pericyclic reaction, which involves your cycloaddition reactions, it involves electrocyclic reactions, then your sigmatropic reactions. This itself is an easy topic, right? In your organic chemistry this is one of the easy topic, but when you combine this particular topic with organic reagents, that particular thing makes the question a little bit tricky to approach, right? And basically what you have to focus on is on the stereochemistry of the product. So that's what we are going to understand in this particular video. I'm going to solve some questions, like around 10 questions in this video, and I hope this will help you to understand this topic a little bit more better. If you have not studied this pericyclic reactions yet and you want to cover this topic, so I have made videos on this particular topic, like cycloaddition reactions, electrocyclic reactions. So those videos are already there on the channel, so you can just click on the link over there that will be on the right side of your screen. So you can just click over there and you can watch those videos first, okay? So yeah, I'll try to explain these questions now. So let's straight away go into the video. Alright, so let's take this particular question, which was asked in CSIR December 2019 exam, and this question was based upon your pericyclic reactions, but yet you have to do a little bit with the organic reagent first of all, okay? So you were given with a particular like a molecule, and you have to react it with H2 in the presence of Lindelar catalyst. That was going to give you a product A, and then with that you are going to get some product B. So that's what it is, okay? That's how the reaction is going to be. So first of all, you should know that what this Lindelar catalyst does, okay? I hope that all of you know already about it. You know that this H2 with Lindelar catalyst, it reduces alkyne to alkene and it forms cis alkene, okay? So what it does, it forms from your alkyne, you are going to get cis alkene, okay? Cis alkene, okay? That's the main function of this H2 Lindelar catalyst is. So that means if I start drawing from this particular bond here, so I'll just make it like this. Now these two bonds are going to get converted into a double bond. So let me make it like this. Then since these are cis, so the next bond, which is these bonds, they are going to be cis to this, okay, like this. So they are now cis to this particular bond, all right. Now again, the next one you can see that you have this double bond, and along with that double bond, this particular one is like E, okay? So this alkene is, you can say that it's E. So if I make it like this, so this is how you can draw this, okay? So you have this, then you have double bond, and then if you want to make it E, along with this single bond and this single bond, they have to be E, okay? So this single bond and this single bond, they are E to each other, okay, or they are trans to each other. That's how you can say, that's what you have done it. And this side you have OH, okay, you have OH. In the same way you can do it for this side as well. You will be having, like, similarly you will be having double bonds here, because here again this is E along with this two sigma bonds, so this goes like this, and then you have this OH. Now you can check out in the options that where you have this is your compound number A, okay, this is your compound number A. So you can check out in the options that which compound has similar properties. So option A will not be correct. Why? Because after this you can see that these like this particular bond is not cis, it's a trans alkene which they have formed, right? This is trans to each other, so this is not going to be the correct option. Same in the second one, yeah, it looks quite similar to that. So second one is our probable answer. Then option number three, if you check out, so here again if you see, so this side it is cis, okay, this side this is cis, but on the other side it is trans. To this is like cis trans type of group which they have made, so that is also not going to be correct one, so you can just cancel out. So and the next one, which you can see option number D over here, so if you look upon the stereo of the groups, so this is cis, right, these two alkenes are cis, fine, and these two alkenes are trans, all right. So this is also, this also can be our probable option. So till now we have two options which can be our probable solution. Okay, so let's go further with the next part, that is you are going to heat this. Okay, now since you are going to heat this, and this particular system is a 4n pi system, okay, this particular system is a 4n pi system, and since you are heating this, so you know that when you heat a 4n pi system, there is a table, right? You know that con, dis, discon, that's how we write down. And we have 4n pi system and 4n plus 2 pi system. Under thermal condition, your 4n pi system does a con rotation, right? That's the table which is there. I'll just attach that small table. I hope that you already know, okay? So yeah, it is going to undergo con rotation, okay? So it's going to go undergo con rotation over here. Now, since you have these two groups going away from each other, okay? They are going to like, so these are going to do con rotation over here. So what should be the stereo of these two groups? Okay, that's what is the main question is. So con rotation of 4n pi system, that's what we know. Now we have to understand that what is the stereo of these two groups. Now there is a shortcut trick to remember that. First of all, you need to see that in which direction these two OH groups are. So with respect to each other, they are opposite in direction. Okay, this is trans to this double bond and this is trans to this double bond. So basically they are going in opposite directions, okay, they are going in opposite direction. So if the direction is opposite and if you are doing cis rotation, then in that case it is going to give you a trans product, okay. So the stereo of the product or stereo of these two groups is going to be trans over here. So the formed product will be this, okay, the rings are going to get it like this, okay. This is how the bonds are going to like the cyclic reaction, this is how it is going to undergo. It's a electrocyclic ring closure reaction. So the ring will close and you will have a 8-membered ring which is going to get formed. You will have double bond here, you will have double bond here, you will have double bond here. And these two groups are going to be like trans to each other. So you can have this OH and then you can have this particular group like OH, okay, this is what it will be. So they will be trans to each other. You can also understand it in this way, that they are going opposite in directions, right? These two groups are going opposite in directions. All right, so when you are done with this up till here, so opposite cis it's going to give you opposite con is going to give you trans. In the next system again you have to heat this, because in the product you can see you have nothing like that. You have double time of pericyclic reactions which have been performed here. So I'm going to do it here, this side like this, okay. So you are going to heat this system once again. Now your system is 4n plus 2 pi system, right? You have 4n plus 2 pi system. Now since the system is 4n plus 2 pi and you are heating that, so the rotation which you will get here will be your dis rotation, okay. So you are going to have a dis rotatory motion over here. Now since the motion is dis, okay, the motion is this, these two groups over here. Now let's draw these hydrogens on this. So the hydrogens which will be there, this hydrogen will be on this side, this will be on this side. Clearly these hydrogens are on opposite side. So O, this is the stereo of these hydrogens, like the position of these two hydrogens. You are doing this rotation. So ODC, this is the trick which we do, ODC. So OCT and ODC. So if you apply that, I have mentioned all these things in my previous videos, okay. So if you have watched them, you know all these tricks and how to apply them. Now ODC is going to tell you that the product should have a cis stereo for these two hydrogen. The cyclic reaction will undergo in this way, that this bond is going to shift like this, this is going to shift over here, this is going to shift over here. A 6-membered ring is going to get formed. So let's form a 6-membered ring, okay. And along with that 6-membered ring, you will have a 4-membered ring downside, which will be involving these two four groups. One of the OH will be above the plane, okay. So you will have OH like this. The other OH will be below the plane, okay. So that's what you have. This is going to be your 6-membered ring along with two bonds over here. And these two hydrogens are going to be cis to each other. So they can be above the plane or they can be below the plane, doesn't matter. Let's make it above the plane. Now look upon the options, that which option satisfies this. So obviously option number B over here satisfies this, okay. Fourth option is not correct, because here the stereo of the last two groups is actually cis, so that is not going to be the correct option, right? So for this question, the correct answer which we will get will be our option number 2. This is going to tell us the correct stereo of the product. Okay, so I hope this was much clear to you. Let's go to the next question then. All right, so we'll talk about this particular question here. It says that the major product formed in the following reaction. The reaction is given to you. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 membered ring. And it's a 3-degree amine which is over here. So it's a 9-membered heterocyclic ring basically which we have. So there are two things which can happen in this case. Okay, the first thing which is like you have thermal condition, and in that you are like what you are doing over here is you are going to have either you can have 4N addition or you can have 4N plus 2 addition. Okay, so that depends upon that what system you are taking into consideration. Now you have two options which are there. These two options are given, C and D are given when you have when you are taking this as a 4N system, okay, that is 4N pi system. And first and second is given when you are taking 6N pi system, okay. So let's try to understand it. So if you are doing this for 4N pi systems, what rings you are going to get? You are going to get two, or basically a bicyclo ring, in which one will be 8-membered ring and the other one will be 3-membered ring. Now obviously, and 3-membered heterocyclic ring. So 8-membered ring, although it has conjugation in that, yet the ring is not that much stable, and the 3-membered ring obviously is a less stable ring as compared to a 5 and 6-membered ring which you will get in option A and B. So rather than undergoing a 4N pi addition, the more preferred way or the more preferred addition is going to be your on the system of 6N pi. That means you just have to consider carbon from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 up to here, that's it. Now you can consider from any way, okay, you can take these from here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. So I've considered it like that. So this is what it is, and under thermal condition, you know it's a 4N plus 2 pi system, right, or a 6 pi system. So it is undergoing disrotation, right, it will undergo disrotation. And if it undergoes disrotation, and let's talk about the stereo of the hydrogens here. So the hydrogen over here will be this, the hydrogen over here will be this. Obviously these two are in opposite directions, so O, D, C. So basically you should have a cis product at the end. So the stereo of the product, stereochemistry of the hydrogens in the product should be cis to each other. So how the reaction will proceed? So this particular bond is going to come here, this will shift this side, this will shift this side. We'll have a 6-membered ring. So let me draw that. This is going to be a 6-membered ring having pi bond here and a pi bond here. And with this particular carbon attached to these two, you will have a 5-membered ring in which adjacent to this you will have nitrogen, and then this is how this will go, okay. And the pi bond is just one carbon adjacent to the nitrogen, so here, okay, this is how it will go. And you will have a methyl group which is attached to this nitrogen over here. Stereo of these two hydrogen is going to be cis. So the stereo of these two hydrogen is going to be cis to each other. All right. So this is how we are going to solve it, and that's what is going to be the answer for this particular question. So option number A is the correct choice for this particular question. All right. I hope you understood. Let's go for the next question then. All right. So let's take the next question then, which was asked in CSIR December 2018 exam. And this particular question seems very simple, but yet it is a little tricky one, okay. This question says that the order of reactivity of the following dienes towards your Diels-Alder reaction. You know what the Diels-Alder reaction is. It's actually 4 plus 2 cycloaddition reaction. So for that, you need, the basic requirement is that you need a diene in the S-cis conformation, okay. So you need a diene in S-cis conformation. Now, S-cis conformation of a diene looks something like this. So a particular diene should look like this in order to undergo Diels-Alder reaction. Now over here, all the options over here which are given are not directly given in the S-cis conformation. These all are in S-trans conformation. We have to convert this S-trans conformation into S-cis conformation first of all. So we have to see that in which of these groups or in which of these options this conversion is much easier. Okay. So there are two factors which decide the reactivity towards the Diels-Alder reaction. The first factor is, so ease of conversion, it should be ease, EASE. So ease of conversion into S cis conformation. And the second thing which you have to look upon will be your crowding at the reacting site. So crowding at reacting site or reaction site. Okay, that's what you need. So basically, if you see, so in this case, the reaction sites will be these two carbons. Okay, these two carbons will be your reaction sites. Now, the first option which is over here, it can easily undergo rotation along this particular sigma bond and it can get converted from this S trans conformation to a S cis conformation. The B also will undergo this particular rotation easily. Why? Because you have a bulky group over here, but you don't have any bulky group over here. You have hydrogen over here. So when you will rotate, there will be not much repulsion and they can undergo like rotation easily. So ease of rotation is in both A and B both. In option C, this ease of rotation is not there. Okay, you cannot rotate it like that. Why? Because of the presence of these two tertiary butyl groups, what you are going to get after the rotation is going to be something like this. So you are going to get S cis, but your tertiary butyl group will be here on the same side, okay, which is going to cause repulsion among each other. Okay, there will be repulsion among each other, and that's what is going to destabilize this rotation. So C, the option number C, is going to stay as a this particular C is going to stay as a particular S trans conformation. It will not get converted into S cis. So the difficult one, the most difficult one, is C. All right. So the order of reactivity will be least for C. So C should be least. If you look upon the options, C is least in option number A itself. But you have to justify A and B both, right? So in A and B both, you can see that there is a ease of reaction, which is, sorry, ease of conversion in both of them. The only difference is that the on the reacting site, reacting sites are these two places, basically the places where you're, okay. So A is going to get converted into something like this. After the conversion, it is going to get converted into this T butyl, all right. And this B is going to get converted into, sorry, it's going to get converted into something like this. You will be having tertiary butyl group here, all right. So if you look upon the reacting sites, so these are the reacting sites, and the crowding over here is in option number A. So in A, you have more crowding at the reaction site. So this S cis conformation, conversion into S cis conformation, is easy for A and B both, but since you have crowding at the reaction site in option number A, that's why its reactivity decreases quite a little bit as compared to B. So that's why B is most reactive, because it has ease of conversion also and there is no crowding at the reaction site. So both of them are going to favor the reaction, like high order of reaction for B, then comes A and then comes C. So option number A is your correct option for this particular question. All right. So this is what it is. If the options would have been given in such a way that there were two of them and they might have changed A and B, then the students might got confused more. Okay. Although the C was smallest one in this, so it was easy to approach towards the option. But yeah, every time you won't be that much lucky. Okay. So you should know the concept, right? That's what it is. Let's go to the next question. All right, so let's look upon the next question again. This was asked from your December 2018 exam, and here you, like, what they have done is they have combined pericyclic reaction with NMR spectroscopy. So you need to know two things over here: organic spectroscopy as well as pericyclic reaction, in order to answer this question completely. It says that the compound P undergoes a pericyclic reaction. This is the compound P, and it undergoes pericyclic reaction under photochemical conditions. Okay, so the condition over here is photochemical. To give some compound Q, you don't know what that compound is. In the compound Q, the relative stereochemistry and the proton NMR chemical shift. So you have to tell the relative stereochemistry of the methyl groups, and you have to tell about the proton NMR chemical shift as well. So what it is going to be, that's what is the question. So let's try to answer this. If this is a molecule P, and if this is undergoing a reaction under photochemical condition, so photochemical condition, you have 4N plus 2 system. You can see that you have over here, because these are the two methyl groups, and if you look upon, this is basically a 6 pi system. So it's a 4N plus 2 pi system, and if you see according to the table, under photochemical condition, 4N plus 2 pi system undergoes your con rotation, right? So this particular group is going to undergo con rotation. Okay, So con rotation, and if you see these two groups, these two methyl groups, what is the direction of them? So this is going in this direction, this is going in this direction. So they are going to be opposite, because they are opposite in direction, they are doing con rotation, so they should be trans, OCT. This is the trick which we are using from the first question as like onwards, okay. So these two methyl groups are going to be trans to each other. So let's draw the molecule, the Q, basically how that is going to look like. So you will have a six membered ring, then you will have again a six membered ring, because this particular bond is going to shift here, this is going to shift here, and this is going to form a sigma bond here. So that's what it is, this sigma bonds come from there, okay. Then you have a group here and this particular six membered ring. Now let's talk about the pi bonds, okay. So the pi bonds are as it is. Here you have these groups like this, all right. Now since this bond has shifted here, so you have a pi bond here, this has shifted here, it is like this, okay. So this is what you will get. The stereochemistry of these two methyl group will be trans. So if this methyl is above the plane, the other methyl should be below the plane. That's what is the stereochemistry of them. Talking about the proton NMR, so you have to know that what kind of system you are in. So basically, if you just ignore the central carbon, if you just look upon the terminal one, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 7 pi system. That means basically you have 14 pi electrons. 14 pi electrons, basically that means the system is of type 4n plus 2 type, right? 4n plus 2 type of system. So that means what? That the system follows the Huckel rule. It's a planar system. So this is going to be a aromatic kind of system. And due to this terminal carbons, due to these terminal double bonds and all, this particular molecule is going to have a aromatic ring current which will be there in the molecule. And wherever you have aromatic ring current, there will be an anisotropic effect. You know about that, right? So you will be having anisotropic effect. Now, anisotropic effect is going to make the particular system in such a way that outer protons, okay, I'll write down these points here. So basically your outer protons, okay, outer protons becomes deshielded. Okay, what happens to them? They becomes deshielded. Okay, they become deshielded. And what about inner protons? So obviously they will be shielded. Okay, so inner ones, inner protons are going to be shielded. Now since they are shielded, and we are going to talk about these methyl groups which are inner side of this particular whole molecule. So these methyl groups are also going to be shielded, and a shielded group is always going to give you chemical shift up field. Okay, so this is going to give you chemical shift up field. So if it is giving you chemical shift up field, and if it is deshielded, so basically the chemical shift will be in a very high value, or it can also be negative. So that goes around -5 ppm, all right. So that's what is going to be the chemical shift for this. So the stereochemistry of the methyl groups become trans, and the chemical shift becomes up field, and that's why it has a negative chemical shift of -5. Okay, so the correct option becomes your option number D, all right. Now let's go for the next question then. All right, so let's look upon this particular question here, which was asked in CSIR June 2018 exam, and this question was a 4-marker question here. It says that the mechanism of the following transformation is what? You are given with this particular molecule, and then you are given with this particular ring, and then you are given with like the condition which is given is a photochemical condition. So just understand that this 4 plus 2 cycloaddition will be suprafacial if your reaction is thermally allowed, okay, if their condition is thermally allowed. Otherwise it will be antrafacial, okay, and if it is antrafacial, your groups will be in the opposite planes and stereo is going to change. For 2 plus 2 addition, it should be in the thermal in the photochemical condition. 2 plus 2 addition in the photochemical condition is going to undergo suprafacial addition. So we prefer suprafacial addition. So basically for this particular molecule, you are going to do 2 plus 2 cycloaddition rather than doing 4 plus 2 cycloaddition under the photochemical condition. So the reaction will be done something like this. You will have the groups like this. Okay, this is the group which we have, and you are going to react it with the alkene which we have over here. Okay, so we have COOET, okay, CO2ET, that's what I have, and here again I have CO2ET. So basically this reaction will undergo in this way, that this is going to attack over here, this pi bond is going to come here, and you are going to form a four membered ring along with this six membered ring, a fused ring over here. Okay, so the product which will be formed will have a six membered ring and fused with a four membered ring. All right, these two pi bonds will remain as it is. You will have, okay, now this pi bond got converted into sigma bond, this also got converted into sigma bond. You have CO2ET over here like that only, okay, CO2ET, and you have a double bond here because this was alkyne, so it got converted into alkene. Now the next thing which you can do over here is, again you are undergoing the same reaction in the photochemical condition itself. So what else you can do? So you can just cancel out option 2 and 3 here, you are just left out with option number 1 and 4. Now over here, since this is alright, so if you see now, this particular system is going to change into a 4 and pi system, right? So basically this is going to be a ring opening reaction, okay, this is going to be a ring opening reaction. And a ring opening reaction of what type? It is going to be of 4 and pi type, okay. Under photochemical condition, 4 and pi system undergoes your disrotation. So this particular system is going to undergo disrotation, okay. So the rotation which will be seen over here will be dis, and if this is a disrotation, so basically this bond is going to shift over here, this is going to shift over here, you are going to form an 8 membered ring. And fine, so what will be the stereochemistry of these two groups? So you know that you are doing disrotation, and these two groups, okay, these two hydrogens are not written, but yet they will be in the same plane. All right, so these two hydrogens, earlier also these two hydrogens were cis to each other, so they will be cis, okay, I'm just drawing them. So if they are cis, so these two hydrogens are cis to each other, you are doing disrotation. So the direction of them in the product should be opposite, okay, then you will get ODC. So in the 8 membered ring which you are going to form, this will be like this, okay. So let me draw this 8 membered ring, that's how it will be. So we will be having double bond here, 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 and here. These two CO2ET will remain as it is, okay, CO2ET will remain as it is. The groups which were there, these two hydrogen will be in the opposite direction, okay, this hydrogen will go in this. So that's why this is going to be the final product. So fine, that gives you that option number 4th is the correct option for this particular question. So 2 plus 2 cycloaddition, let me just write down here. So this was 2 plus 2 cycloaddition reaction, and along with that you have a dis rotatory ring opening reaction. That's how you are going to get the product. All right, now let's go to the next question. All right guys, so we'll talk about this particular question which was asked in CSIR December 2017, and again it was a 4 marker question. Here again we have a reagent along with the pericyclic reaction, okay. So this question is on sigmatropic reaction. It says that the given reactant and the product is given to you, catalyst is given to you, and what you have to do is you have to find out that what kind of sigmatropic reaction is actually undergoing over here, okay, or whether there is a CH insertion happening over here or not. So if you look upon the molecule, there are few things which you can find out. First of all is what you can see is that this N2 is not there in the product, okay, so you don't have N2 in the product side. Second thing which you can see is that this oxygen bond along with this oxygen is breaking, so that means there might be something happening with this bond, probably the sigmatropic reaction happening with this particular bond. And now let's look upon the the catalyst. So this catalyst is used to form carbene, right? It's used to form carbene. So basically what you are going to have is this, okay. You guys have to tell me in the comments which catalyst it is, what is the name of this particular catalyst, okay. So that you guys have to tell me in the comments. So just look upon it, we have N2 over here, we have double bond O over here, then we have oxygen over here, we have a group, methyl group like this, and then we have something like this. The catalyst, I'm not going to write down the whole name of catalyst, just in the presence of this. Okay, fine. So RH2, okay, so RH2OAC, we have OAC, okay, OAC whole 4. Okay, that's the catalyst which we have taken. So in that presence, what is going to happen? This N2 is going to get evolved, and what you are going to form is something like this. Okay, so your oxygen will remain as it is, this methyl group will remain as it is, the rest of the like substituent will remain as it is, double bond O will remain as it is. Here you will have a carbene formed. Okay, so this is a carbene which is actually formed. Now you know that oxygen will have lone pair of electrons, so basically what is going to happen over here, that it's because carbene being electrophilic in nature, it's going to attract these electrons of this oxygen, and that's what is going to happen here. So what is going to form, I'll just write down over here, so you are going to form something like this. Okay, so you will have oxygen at this particular place, a particular substituent are over here, then you will be having a six membered ring formed, double bond O is there. All right, now understand that there will be certain charges which will develop. Since it is carbene and it has accepted electrons, so it should get a negative charge, and this oxygen, it has donated electrons and it is forming three bonds, so it will gain a positive charge. Now this is highly unstable molecule, because you should not have positive charge on electronegative groups, but yet you have that. So you have done one of the part of it, that means you have removed. Okay, so what has happened in this, that N2 has just gone evolved on this. Okay, so being a nitrogen gas, it just evolved. Okay, so in the next step, you have to break this bond, because in the product side you don't have anything attached with the oxygen. Oxygen is only dimeric, like it's only forming two bonds, right? So now you can understand that from where to where your sigmatropic reaction might be happening. So keep this bond as one, keep this bond as one, one, one. Now start numbering it. So this is two, this is three. Up till here we have conjugation, so just number it here, and this will undergo up till here because you have the charge over here. So now this particular sigmatropic rearrangement is a 2-3 sigmatropic rearrangement. I'll tell you how. So this is basically 2-3 sigmatropic, like sigmatropic reaction. Okay, so STR I'll write down. So sigmatropic reaction, that's what you have, and it's a 2-3 sigmatropic reaction. You can see that this particular bond is going to break like this. This pi bond is going to attack on this, and this fine. So this particular negative charge is going to get eliminated by this particular pi bond attack, and that's what you are going to form. So the final product will be in this way. You are going to just form the final product now. So your final product will be your product, which is here. Okay, or you can draw it also, you can check it out. So you will have the groups like this, oxygen over here. Okay, the one methyl group was here with oxygen. Now the bond has been broken, everything got attached over here, and how many carbons? 1, 2, 3 carbon. So 1, 2, and 3 carbon. The new pi bond will be formed, so I'll just number it. So this was 3, this was 2, and this was 1. The new pi bond will be formed between 1 and 2, so 1 and 2 will form that pi bond, and this double bond O obviously was there, right? Double bond O. Fine, so that's your product, and that is how this reaction has happened. So the main reaction which was here was your 2-3 sigmatropic reaction. So carbene formation followed by 2-3 sigmatropic reaction was the way how we will answer this question. Okay, fine. Now let's go to the next question. All right, so this question again was asked in CSIR December 2017 exam. Again, you have to do two things over here. First is you have to undergo pericyclic reaction, and in the second, you are given with a particular catalyst, you have to react with that. Okay, so fine, let's do it. So in the first step, you can see that this particular molecule is forming this molecule. Okay, now very much like there was a lot of confusion when people approached this particular question, and when it came in CSIR December 2017 exam, they thought that okay, this is a 4n pi system. Under thermal condition, 4n pi system undergoes cis rotation. Okay, and they just it undergoes con rotation. So they just undergo for the con rotation, and they answered it in that way. But the correct way of approaching this particular question was like this, that since you are given with the thermal condition, in the product you can see that this pi bond is not undergoing the pericyclic reaction. It is as it is, only this six membered or this particular six pi bonds are undergoing this pericyclic reaction. So actually the system over here is 4n plus 2 pi system, okay. So you have 4n plus 2 pi system, and 4n plus 2 pi system under thermal condition, what kind of rotation it undergoes? So this undergoes disk rotation, okay. So con disk, disk con, that's how you can remember it. So it undergoes disk rotation. So the first thing is 4n plus 2 pi and disk rotation. So you just got your answer basically. And if you look upon it, so you will get this, that's fine. And then if you react it with osmium tetraoxide, that is OSO4, you know that it does cis addition of your OH group. So your OH groups are going to attack on the isolated carbonyl, on the isolated alkene, okay, not in the conjugated alkene. So isolated alkene is going to undergo cis addition of OH group, and that's how you are going to get the final product. So your option number 2 is the correct option. I hope you understood, right? So once you are done with this, you can understand the other product easily. All right, so we'll go for the last question for this particular video. This was again a very simple question. It was asked in CSIR December 2017 exam, and these types of questions are generally asked, and you should be aware about that, how to solve them. The question says that according to the Frontier molecular orbital theory, the highest occupied molecular orbital for hexatriene in the following reaction is. So now you are given with the photochemical condition. So remember, in the photochemical condition, your hexatriene is going to have six molecular orbitals, right? It is going to have six molecular orbitals, right? And if you have six molecular orbitals, and under photochemical conditions, your HOMO is going to be your Psi4, right? Your n, like n by 2 plus 1 is going to be the HOMO in the photochemical condition. So Psi4 will be your HOMO. Now once you understood the HOMO, you can find out number of nodes in that. So number of nodes in this particular Psi4 is going to be how much? That is going to be 1 less than whatever the molecular orbital you are. Psi1 has 0 nodes, Psi2 has 1 node, Psi4 will have 3 nodes. Okay, so it will have 3 nodes. Now you have to look upon the options, and you have to see that which of the option has 3 nodes. If you look upon the first option here, it has 1 node here. So this is the first node which we have, and the second node. So you have 2 nodes in this case. In option number 2, you have 1 node here. You just have to see that where the sign is changing. Okay, again one more node. So 2 nodes again in option number 2. In option number 3, you can see that there is just 1 node which is there at the center. In option number 4, you can see there is 1 node here. Then you have 1 node here because the sign is changing here. Again, you have 1 more node here. So you got 3 nodes in option number 4, and that's going to denote your Psi4, and that's going to be your HOMO for the particular reaction. Okay. So this is how you have to approach this particular question. I hope this was much simple and like you all understood it. Alright. So yeah. Alright guys, so that's it from my side for this particular video. I hope the questions which we have taken in the class, in this particular video, you have understood them, you got to know that how to solve them. I hope you got to know quite a few new things, quite a few new tricks, how to approach pericyclic reactions. See, these are very simple ones. You just need to see the reaction properly. You have to analyze the product properly if it is given, and you should be aware about some general reagents, okay? So that is going to help you to solve questions from pericyclic reaction. So that's all from my side. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, give it a like. You can ask your doubts, or if you have any suggestions, you can give that in the comment sections below. I'll see you guys in the next video. Till then, have a great day. Bye bye.